in advancement of Uganda, the government of Uganda is into investments, but one of the critical opportunities that Uganda is harvesting is oil exploration and exploitation. But we need to always ask ourselves, where does this leave the ordinary person, specifically in their ecological kind of living? We know that we have the East African crude oil pipeline, which is being constructed now. And there are too many underlying issues that need to be addressed by the government. So many project-affected people have not yet been compensated. And even if there is a model to compensate them, this they have not been involved. So there is no participation, adequate participation for everyone. In some of our interventions, we have also found out that if you have your plot of land and the pipeline is going to go through maybe the middle or the other half of the land, now they will not be compensating you for the remaining part. Another example is the land we have made people aware the pipeline is going to be going in through their backyard. And now the companies have told them that they should be, you know, staying in their houses while having the pipeline going through their backyard. So we think this is not sustainable. We actually don't know what will happen to the people. And the pipeline is going to traverse many protected areas of Uganda, dissecting through what we call an ecosystem of biodiversity. This pipeline, if it is implemented the way it is, Uganda is going to lose very critical and threatened species, including some of the birds, some of the special types of fish. And we don't know what is going to happen to both surface water and underground water. When you look at the EIA, it is inconclusive on what is going to be done. Our appeal to government is, we do not want to sound as if we are anti-development. No, but sustainable development comes along with looking into many other aspects. In consideration of this pipeline, there is nothing to cater for the elderly. That is gross. The youth, the women, in some of the instances, our intervention has shown that even the negotiation for compensation is negotiated with men. Some men have multiple homes and partners. Then others are sidelined. That is dangerous. Another thing that we want government and the partners to look into is the adequate compensation. And this is our model that we want to put before you. If you care about human rights, that is, how can you just compensate me for the plot of land and you don't put into consideration other ecosystem issues or social cohesion? It is this community where I have lived all my time. I have my friends here, I can go to the well, I can go and fetch firewood, I can get my food. Now you are telling me to relocate and go to another locality. Who pays for that? Who pays for the inconvenience? Who pays? And we insist on the payment, not because we want so much payment, no, but because we know that this is a profitable venture. Whoever is investing in, who has the biggest share majority, the majority shares in the pipeline, they'll be making money at the end of the day. Yet the people who were, you know, belonging to these communities are really going to suffer without any adequate compensation. The last thing that I want to speak about, linking investment, well-being, but also human rights, is the Lake Victoria Basin. I want to appeal to all the duty bearers and partners who are concerned and who are constructing this pipeline. The moment you go into the Lake Victoria Basin, you are going to, science indicates that you are going now to traverse the critical catchment areas, not only for water, but also as a breeding area for fish. And who knows, what if we have oil spill that goes into this Victoria lake that we have, which is not only serving Uganda, East Africa as a whole, and Africa. So we want to appeal to you, if it can be relocated and does not go through the Lake Victoria Basin, you'll have served right the ecosystem, and you'll have cut back on the emission that needs to be, that shouldn't be, the carbon that will be coming into the air. We need to remind ourselves that the climate change is eating into us. This shouldn't be the time when we involve ourselves in activities which are going to injure not only the environment, but the entire ecosystem, the food security of everyone, and food safety, including health of the people. Where are they going to get medication, for example, if they fall sick? Because we know many communities are going to stay near the pipeline. How are they going to, in case of the eventualities, who is going to take the precaution for them? So I want to appeal to the East African Community Secretariat that this is the time that the Secretariat should work. We want to appeal to the summit, the East African Community Summit, that if you care about the people, the East African, let us not only look at the money, but let us put lives and people first.